Imagine you woke up one morning, made a cup of coffee, cracked a few eggs, and turned on your TV to some mainstream, so-called trusted news source like the BBC or CNN. You sit down to enjoy your breakfast, and you hear the news anchor say, "Breaking news! We have confirmation that the sky is now green. I repeat, the sky is now green." You think that's an odd thing to say. I mean, the sky is blue, right? It's always been blue. You even look out your window to check. And sure enough, the sky is still blue. But the suit on the TV says it's green. And all of the guest journalists from The Guardian, The Financial Times, BuzzFeed, they're all nodding their heads and agreeing. The sky is indeed green, and it's bloody wonderful too. The news anchor then says, "Our Twitter feed is on fire this morning with reactions to this breaking news. Let's have a read of some of them." And he begins to read out a list of responses from people watching. Most are receptive to the news, but some agree with you. What do you think about this, Owen Jones?
Well, I think it shows the true level of ignorance we have in this divided country. How some people in 2019 can still believe the sky is blue says everything you need to know about the toxic brand of right-wing politics that rules over us.
The other journalists nod their heads and agree once again. What about you, Afua Hirsch?
Well, I think we need to redefine what blue actually means. These days, the modern incarnation of blue is more greenish. And to say the sky has always been blue is simply wrong and reeks of bigotry. Ugh.
Everyone again nods and agrees, and they also agree to call people like you backwards. You're stuck in your ways. You are anti-progressive, and worst of all, you are a sky denier. You aren't to be listened to. You aren't to be trusted. You are the past, not the bright, green future we should be embracing. Your coffee goes cold, you lose your appetite, and you look outside your window at that beautiful blue sky and think, "Is it me? Am I the problem? I wish I could just be colorblind and not notice that the sky is actually blue when everyone else is saying it's green. Maybe I am just a narrow-minded skyist. I'd best not mention it ever again." Okay, a simplistic analogy there, but you get what I mean, don't you? We, in the West, live in a world where up is down, blue is green, and truths are lies. We go through our days being told to change our ways, to get with the program, to upgrade our thinking, because we are the relics of a more primitive, insular time. And frankly, our points of view just aren't acceptable anymore. No matter how ridiculous the claim, how completely and obviously inaccurate it is, if the powerful backers in the media want to push an agenda, oh, they will do it. And if you aren't on board, you will be smeared, attacked, and made to feel like you are a bad person. Like you have something wrong with you for thinking the way you do. But something has changed lately. The powers that be in the media are lashing out clumsily. The mask is slipping ever more. I was mainly inspired to make this video because of the mainstream media's reaction to my reinstatement on YouTube this past week. Up until recently, I've received very little attention from journalists, but it seems like the toys are really starting to get thrown out of the pram now. And it's interesting. Places such as the BBC, CNN, and Business Insider have directly mentioned me within articles, as well as other sites like BuzzFeed, for example. All in a negative way, of course. None of them are glad that I'm back on YouTube, let's make that perfectly clear. And none of them said a word when I was actually banned. It was only when I came back that they decided to say something. Like I said, most of the articles just mention me by name. No real detail there. They just refer to me as a far-right video maker. Whatever. But CNN did something more. CNN put a hyperlink in their article on my name, which, when clicked, takes you to an article by BuzzFeed, who say a few more things. The Iconoclast has more than 200,000 subscribers on YouTube. In an interview with Defend Europa last year, the YouTuber spoke extensively about the white nationalist conspiracy theory of ethnic replacement. He describes himself as a British nationalist who is anti-mass migration. Interesting. The fact that CNN actually linked to this article shows how dirty they really are. The white nationalist conspiracy theory of ethnic replacement. Ah, okay, so it's a conspiracy theory, is it? Well, I apologize. You see, I was only getting my information from mainstream left-wing news sources that have reported on white demographics for years. Silly me. Newspapers such as The Guardian, for example, which in the year 2000, 19 years ago, published the infamous piece, The Last Days of a White World. We are near a global watershed, a time when white people will not be in the majority in the developed world, Britain included. In Britain, the number of ethnic minority citizens has risen from a few tens of thousands in the 1950s to more than 3 million, or around 6% of the total population. While the number of whites is virtually static, higher fertility and net immigration means the number from ethnic minorities is growing by 2 to 3% a year. One demographer, who didn't want to be named for fear of being called racist, oh, that's cute, said, "It's a matter of pure arithmetic that, if nothing else happens, non-Europeans will become a majority and whites a minority in the UK. That would probably be the first time an indigenous population has voluntarily become a minority in its historic homeland." Ah, tell you what, the bloody Guardian and their conspiracy theories, eh? Ugh, shameful. How dare they write this article? I'm sure CNN will write something about this very, very soon. They'll call out this author. They'll find out who that racist demographer was and they'll dox him. Yeah, right. They aren't the only ones, though, apparently. The Independent has also written articles about demographic predictions. There have been countless pieces written about towns and cities in the UK becoming minority white British. The New York Times have written about how the looming white minority in America worries certain demographers because they fear a political backlash. I mean, why anyone would be angry about becoming a minority in their own country baffles me, it really does. And then, the best one, CNN's own golden boy, Anderson Cooper himself, openly chit-chatted about it on television, which was something I didn't know until Red Ice TV brought it to my attention, so thank you for that. Here's the clip.
You know, whites will not be the majority. I mean, it's an exciting transformation of the country. It's an exciting evolution and, you know, progress of our country in many different ways. Clearly, there's, you know, among white supremacists, white nationalists, that is viewed as a horrific event.
It's immediate how they spin that and turn that around. Yeah. Oh, actually, I just realized that was an admission of what they are talking about. Actually, that's bad. You can't say that that's bad. If you think it's exciting, it's happening, and it's happening. But now, you know, these white supremacists, though, they're crazy for thinking this is happening. It's amazing.
Oh, Anderson Cooper, a conspiracy theorist that could rival Alex Jones. It really is amazing. So yes, let me get this straight. Demographic replacement is a conspiracy theory, but hang on, we're saying it's actually happening and that it's a good thing. As Anderson Cooper says, it's an exciting change. So basically, the media will accuse you of lying if you don't support it, but put you on national television if you think it's good. Well, it's nice to know where I stand. Thank you. Morons. But I have to ask these publications a very important question, so guys, if you're watching, which I'm sure you are, please get back to me. The question is, why do you care about me at all? Seriously, I have just over 200,000 subscribers on a website. You all get millions upon millions of clicks, huge advertiser revenue. You, the BBC, get publicly funded by chumps like me. You all have 10 times the reach I have. You all have access to all the right people. You have a default level of respect and acceptance, purely because you are the mainstream media. And here I am, a 29-year-old bloke from a small northern town in England with a laptop and a microphone. What's the big problem, eh? I've been completely demonetized by YouTube, so financially I'm no threat to you. My videos get stifled by algorithms. My current subscribers don't get notified as often as they should about my new content. I'm barely ever recommended to new viewers. Meanwhile, funnily enough, you guys get promoted to the hilt on YouTube all of the time. Liberalism dominates Western culture. All of your political and social opinions are backed up in society. Everything you've ever campaigned for has been given to you. Abortion, gay marriage, trans rights, mass immigration, and so on. Hollywood is on your side. Big business is on your side. Transnational political unions are on your side. None of your journalists would ever get fired for preaching about their left-wing views on the internet. Your friends won't abandon you, your family won't disown you. Every single thing that comes out of your mouths, gets written on your websites, gets uttered on your television channels, are the safest, most politically correct opinions that exist anywhere in the world, and you're all making a killing. So, again, the question. What is it about me and all the other channels that you have written about this week that you find so bloody worrying? Is it because, possibly, that I and the hundreds of thousands of people who follow me are still refusing to jump on the globalist bandwagon? Could it be that your handlers over at the ADL are starting to see that their brand of bullshit only flies so far? Or could it be the realization that if I and others had access to the resources you people have, all the money, all the airtime, all the corporate sponsorships, we'd blow you all out of the water, and your ideology would be a total laughingstock, and millions of people would happily join us and proudly proclaim from their rooftops that the sky isn't fucking green, it's blue, always has been, and always will be. Your worldview, your pushing of globalism is universally unpopular. The only hope you people have is censorship. Because you know you simply can't compete with the truth. You can't compete with the public's views. Your only hope there is to wear down the people to such an extent that they will give up out of apathy. You know what I'm talking about. Stop Brexit. Refugees welcome. Trans men in schools. Gay pride 365 days a year. Hate speech laws. No white applicants allowed. Sexist, racist, fascist, Islamophobe. Pray for Christchurch. Take your guns. Sri Lanka, what? Charlie Hebdo had it coming. Diversity is our strength. British Empire, bad. Open the borders, let them in. More ping pong tables for murderers. Demographic replacement is exciting. It's not working anymore, lads. You've gone too far. You've blown it. And that's all I really want to say on the matter. BBC, CNN, ADL, we see you. Hiya, how's it going? Thank you so much for directing even more viewers to my channel this week. I'll be sure to treat all these new people very well indeed. Cheers. Thank you so much for watching once again. If you'd like to support this channel, you can do so via PayPal, the link is down below, or you can buy a copy of the Iconoclast magazine. Issue 005 is now released. I'm very proud of it, and I hope you enjoy reading it. The link to my website is down below. You can buy it in both physical and digital versions. I'll see you all soon. Have a good one. Bye-bye.